Fida, I actually met John on drums about 15 years ago. We're both from South Wales. And I kind of knew John, but we were in different bands, and there was a little bit of friendly competition between the two of us. And we eventually ended up in the same band in Cardiff, a rock band. I moved down to London and found a job in a recording studio and started to sort of write kind of more and more music and learn how to engineer. And then John moved down about 2 years after me, and we formed this band Feeder. And then we found Taco after he put an ad in Loot. I just think that there's kind of more of an awareness at the moment here for rock bands. And I think, you know, certainly, you know, there's some UK rock bands who are doing really well. People like Muse and Ash, who are in the same boat as us. I mean, really. So that has helped a bit. I think people have got so bored of the whole boy band scene and the whole kind of processed pop stuff that's been, you know, kind of dominating the charts here for so long, and is still dominating the charts. I think it has given a little bit of a room for us.
That have gone that extravagant on video budgets, you know. 7 Days in the Sun was the most expensive video we've ever done. And I think that was almost double what Buck Rogers cost as well, you know. So it's been a gradual climb up to the spending on videos.
Well, actually, it wasn't our idea. It was our director said, oh, have an elephant on the video, or have it going to Cape Town, it would be nice and cheaper. But that's what we were told. That's why we said, okay, go to Cape Town, yeah, have a nice holiday.
It always helps to have a few, you know, three beautiful women in the video, wouldn't you, you know?
I prefer the elephant as well.
All right.
Yeah.
I think the intense media pickup for us has been quite recently, really, from last December. Obviously, we were touting Buck Rogers at that time.
I think for me, it was actually when I wrote High. I think that was a turning point for us as well. Although we didn't have the big kind of media exposure, it was a song that it was our first sort of big radio song. So for me, that it's been a build, you know, really from High onwards. He's got a brand new car. Wish I could take you up. It's got leather seats. It's got a CD player. But I don't wanna talk about it anymore. I think we're gonna make it. I think we're gonna save it, yeah. Try and fake it anymore, anymore. the Standing on the Edge is a pretty good one, don't you?
That's good. Yeah.
Yeah. Think? Well, we got, you know, well, some singles we had on the set list, but well, I don't like people just judge us because of this single, because we have more different, you know,
style.
Mm. So Standing Edge is quite unusual, maybe for ordinary listeners, but you know, mm-hmm.
it's got a few yeah. moods to it as well, Standing on the Edge. Mm. So, and also, I mean, you can be into a track depending on your mood. You know, people say, "What's your favorite song on the album?" Depends what mood I'm in. You know, but Standing on the Edge has got different moods to it. So I suppose it collaborates all the moods. Mm. So,
I mean, there was a few songs on the album like Choke and Standing on the Edge, which were sort of ideas sort of came up in the studio and just kind of went in there and jammed things out and put them down ourselves. You know, we didn't work with Gil on every song. But for me, that was fun, and it was like being sort of, you know, going back to when we first started, when we just used to go into a barn in yeah. Wales and just like turn the amps up on full volume and just play loud. I mean, obviously, you know, I can only do a certain amount at home because, okay, I can get the song, I can do the lyrics and the music, fine. But you still need to hear it, you know, often with a band at loud volume and to see if it's going to work on a live point of view as well.
Oh,
time to face the real thing. So what am I? Tomorrow.
And I know, obviously, this day and age, it's quite easily accessible to access a band through internet. But we're still firm believers that, you know, to receive something through your letterbox is really important, you know. So we do. It's like we've got this little...
That's what it is.
It does. We've got this little fanzine, you know, that we send out to people. I remember when I used to be a member of certain bands' fan clubs, you know, to get even Culture Club, to get something through the door is better than actually seeing it on a screen, you know. It's important to give something back to the fans. I used to get feather boas and lipstick and things, yeah, and condoms. But I didn't mind. I mean, you know, it was nice to have.
Counting the lines on my face. Cheers.